A very important study has been published online in the June 6th issue of Lancet Oncology. This study comes from the MD Anderson Hospital, and one of my surgery colleagues there, Anthony Lucci, is the lead author. Dr. Lucci is a surgical oncologist, breast specialist like myself. And the study is about circulating tumor cells. What are circulating tumor cells? Well, I've said to patients for years that once a cancer becomes invasive and starts growing out through the walls of the ducts, that they have the potential to break off and to circulate tumor cells around the body, traveling probably through either the lymphatic or venous systems. And we've known for over 30 years that with invasive breast cancer, we have to treat the whole body. And it's primarily because of these cells that are elsewhere in the body. Now, the whole issue of circulating tumor cells has been something that's been around for a while. Measurements have been done of circulating tumor cells historically in women who have advanced breast cancer. And remember now, what's advanced breast cancer? Stage 4 breast cancer. And looking at and measuring the circulating tumor cells in advanced breast cancer while a patient is receiving treatment has been one of the ways of monitoring, if you will, the effectiveness of the treatment. So the study that's coming out of the MD Anderson Hospital is really important because, to my knowledge, and I think theirs, this is one of the first ever studies, prospective study, if you will, on looking at circulating tumor cells in non-metastatic breast cancer. In other words, folks who don't have stage 4 disease. And the report is quite important. And I've got some of the notes and documentation right here, and I've had a chance to review this article myself. About 25% of the 302 women studied in this particular prospective study were found to have one or more circulating tumor cells with a standard technique that they used to detect these circulating tumor cells. Now, why was that number important? Because in those who had one or more detected circulating tumor cells, they had a 4 times greater risk of relapse, of their cancer coming back, and of course, with relapse, the potential of dying. Also, interestingly, as the number of circulating tumor cells increased, the greater the number, then proportionally, it sounds like the greater the risk of the cancer relapsing elsewhere in the body and coming back. Now, historically, what we've used to stage patients has been the TNM system, tumor, lymph nodes, distant metastasis. I think all of us in the field have realized some of the inadequacies of that approach. A good example is that we know that lymph node negative breast cancers can in fact recur, systemically fail, and die down the road. So we need something more. And I think this study of circulating tumor cells is going to allow us to begin to stratify patients with the standard staging system that we have once this approach is finally used clinically. And I want to emphasize right now, and Dr. Lucci emphasizes this also, this particular approach is not ready for prime time, at least right now. And I'll tell you more about that in just a second. But I can envision that in addition to things like the Oncotype DX study, that finding circulating tumor cells is going to help us a lot in the future when this is ready for prime time to help us estimate, if you will, or predict what are the chances of systemic failure down the road and relapse and potentially death. So there is going to be a podcast that accompanies this video here at Breast Cancer Answers. The podcast I've listened to, it's excellent with Dr. Lucci and one of his colleagues at the MD Anderson, goes into the study in really, really great depth, points out the limitations right now, And quite frankly, if we started doing this on everybody tomorrow, how is it going to change how we're going to treat people? In other words, would more chemotherapy work? We don't know the answer to that question. Would being longer on anti-hormonal therapy work if we knew there was a higher risk of relapse? More to be revealed with more clinical trials that should come from this. Now, one of the things that I found particularly exciting in listening to the podcast and reading the paper will be our ability in the future to take these individual tumor cells and to learn more about them and the biology of them. So as an example, you can find HER2 new circulating tumor cells in a patient whose primary tumor isn't HER2 new positive. That would have great implications, obviously, when it comes to treating these cells or finding them and further treatment for patients, et cetera, et cetera. So just quickly looking at my notes, what we need is more in the way of clinical trials. We're going to need more information from this. I want to emphasize this once again. This is not a standard of care, but what this is doing, for those of you who follow us here at Breast Cancer Answers, what this is doing is giving us more information to stratify patients, more of a focus for our future research and treatment efforts. My congratulations go to Dr. Lucci and his colleagues at the MD Anderson. This is really an important piece of work. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.